Congressman with a Bravo Zulu Award. The Bravo Zulu Award. The Bravo Zulu Award is a military acronym which means well done. And we want to recognize him for his outstanding leadership by example. Because we've learned about Mr. Usman, if there's a good cause or people in need from any community, any financial demographic, all you have to do is ask. And the man is all over it, and he's an example to us all. Round of applause, please. At the same time, we would like to take the moment as well to present Mr. Usman with a first responder supporter certificate because of his extensive support of the police, the fire department, and the paramedics, not only in the city of Markham, in the region of York, but as well, we believe, in the province of Ontario, and his example is Team Canada-wide. Again, a round of applause. So I've taken enough of your time. Without further ado, the first award that we're going to present Mr. Usman is...
Bravo Zulu.
Canadian military, police, firefighters, and paramedics. Thank So ladies and gentlemen, just so you have a little background, and we'll be very quick. Red Friday, remember everyone deployed, was started in 2006 for the Army in Afghanistan. And the idea generally was that you would remember all of the service personnel that serve our country and keep us safe. Last year, with the help of Mayor Scarpitti, the City of Markham, and the Council from the City of Markham, we were graciously partnered with the city so that we could get the word out more eloquently and more forcefully across Canada so that people would begin to wear red on Fridays, remembering the emergency services and the military that protect them and allow us to continue with our way of life. So, without further ado, thank you for your kind time, thank you for your kind attention.
Up here, I'm going to take a minute to introduce our next speaker. The simplest introduction of Mayor Scarpitti is that he is a man who is passionate about his responsibilities. He is a visionary. He works 7 days a week, about 18 hours a day, all year round. Sorry, Nancy. Markham and York region is in his blood. He has a vision of Markham, and because of that, we have grown from a small town of 60,000 when my dad came to Markham, to now over 335,000. It is the high-tech capital of Canada. I can definitely keep going on and on, but time is short. So please put your hands together to welcome the co-chair, Mr. Frank Scarpitti.
Well, thank you very much, Rabia. Good evening, everyone. Assalamu alaikum. It is a pleasure to be here once again for the 16th annual COPA Gala. And before I recognize just a few dignitaries, I want to say thank you to my co-chair, Khaled Usman, because we both have that title, but in terms of balance, co really applies to me, chair really applies to Khaled Usman, because he just does an outstanding job organizing this event. So congratulations, Khaled. Consul General Siddiqui, I just want to say thank you very much for gracing us with your presence again this evening. The Consul General, since his arrival, has truly been an amazing partner for the city of Markham, someone who is committed to the Pakistani community, someone who I think reflects the community well and cares about the community. And I am so pleased that once again, I told the Consul General when he arrived, you better hold this event at the city of Markham. And he continues to do so. And I hope that you're able to join us on Sunday morning when once again, we will raise the Pakistani flag at the Markham Civic Center to honor the great contribution the Pakistani community has made. And it is wonderful tonight that we are joined by so many political representatives. I want to say first and foremost, thanks to the Markham Council and the great work that they do, because together we've made tremendous progress. And I want to say thank you as well. I can't let the moment go by to say thank you to the ministers that are here this evening, because through their collective decisions, they really have supported our community. And as late as today, I want to say a special thank you to Minister Helena Jasek. In her announcement today, Markham Stouffville Hospital is getting another $10.2 million to support our local hospital. I also want to recognize Minister Reza Maridi. Minister Maridi, I just want to say thank you to you, because we've been able to make great progress here in the city of Markham. I thank you for the very, very strong support and the support of Minister Mitzi Hunter and Minister Michael Chan. But I say thank you to you, because without you, we would never have had a new campus for York University here in the city of Markham. So thank you for the great support. Now, I've never heard our police chief be introduced as the lovely police chief. And I can tell you, maybe on a Friday night, he looks his best. But I can tell you that throughout the week, he and Deputy Chief Kareek and Deputy Chief Crawford and the entire organization, the men and women of York Regional Police, they are working hard on our behalf. They're keeping our community safe. They're building bridges each and every opportunity they get. And I want to tell you that the chief just stepped out his own personal time to go to Pakistan and visit Pakistan, and he's just come back from that trip. I think he is an amazing example of how he reaches out to so many of the cultural groups. So thank you for the great work. I don't know how you're able to look so lovely after all of that, but you're able to do it. You know, it doesn't feel like 16 years, but this community has come together at this event to show its love for Canada. It's come together to show its love for our community. It's come together of all the cultural groups, and we are the most diverse city in all of Canada. And the Pakistani community is an important community here in Markham, because one of the charities tonight that's getting more money is Markham Stouffville Hospital. But I want to tell you that these 16 years of your support has meant that the Pakistani community has contributed the largest amount of dollars from any other cultural group in the city of Markham, over $2 million to Markham Stouffville Hospital. So I thank you for the way in which you've come together to demonstrate your support for our community, a hospital that welcomes people of all backgrounds, that doesn't ask you to see your passport when you come through the front door. They don't ask you how long you've lived here, how many generations has your family been here. When you walk through that door, they recognize that they're there to provide health care to our community. And I thank Joanna and her team at Markham Stouffville Hospital for the way in which they provide excellent health care to all of our community in the city of Markham. And then to the Global Peace Center of Canada. This is an institution that I think we should all be proud of. Inspired by the young Malala Yousafzai, someone who faced personal tragedy, personal adversity, and at her young age, dealing with the trauma of being shot, inspired the world to say, the only way that we will overcome hatred, the only way that we will overcome violence, the only way that we will overcome terrorism, no matter who the victims are, is by strengthening young girls around the world and giving them an education so that they'll know better. That's the way we strengthen the world. And so here is an institution in Canada that's been inspired by her to look at ways that we can bring peace in every corner of the world. And I'll tell you, there's nothing more Canadian, nothing more Canadian than reaching our hand, helping someone out, going to different parts of the world to make sure that people are safe, that they can go to school, that they can reach their full potential. This is Canada, and there's no better place than to have the Global Peace Center right here in this great country. And finally, to the Social Services Network. This is an organization who now has been around for a few years, who recognized that in the most diverse city of Canada, there are language barriers. There are cultural barriers. And I can tell you that for anyone who's lived in our country for a long time and needs help for a family member for social services, the maze to get the right help is difficult for everyone. But they recognize that cultural differences, language barriers, makes it that much more difficult for the South Asian community to connect to the right people and to get the right help. And I applaud the work that they do in our community because they've broken down those barriers. They've reached into the South Asian community and made the connection to the agencies and to the organizations where people can feel that they've been helped. As good as we are to say we've opened up the doors to Canada, that is not enough, because if we sit idly by and let those that need help be ignored in our community, then that's not the Canada that we want. And I salute the social services for the way they brought the community connected to the people reach their full potential. But the beauty of Canada is not that alone. Yeah. It's having everyone participate, everyone contribute, because as strong as we are today, thanks to the Pakistani community and many others who've come to this great country, we are going to get stronger as time goes on. And I say thank you for the amazing contributions all of you have made. Thank you, and have a great night.
So before we continue further, I want to take this time to remind you all of the raffle that is set up in the corner of the room over there. If you have not bought your tickets as yet, please go ahead and do so, as all proceeds from the raffle are going straight to Markham Stovall Hospital. Thank you. So next, it is my pleasure to invite the Consul General of Pakistan, Imran Ahmed Siddiqui, to bring greetings on behalf of Pakistani Canadians and Pakistanis in general. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen, and a very good evening. According to World Tolerance Map, Pakistan is one of the most tolerant countries in the world. So on account of being tolerant and giving and sharing our wealth, our happiness and whatever we have with others is something that we should be really proud of. I wish to thank Mayor's Carpentry for hosting this event, for co-chairing this organization with Khadr Usman Bhai. Years after years for holding this gala, and years after years hosting us and hosting Pakistan Day celebration at his office. This year also we are we will hold our Pakistan Day celebration at the Mayor's office on 25th of March, Sunday. I invite all of you to the event. And I also, on behalf of the Premier's office, invite you to the Premier's celebration for Pakistan Day, which is going to hold tomorrow in Thorncliffe School. Thank you very much again for holding this great event. And I wish you all very well, particularly Khadr Usman Bhai, who is not only a great philanthropist and a great social worker, but also an adventurer, because sometimes we see him on the top of Everest in the month of June, and in the month of January we see him, you know, in the desert of Sahara. So through his photos we are learning a lot as to how this world looks like. So thank you very much once again.
It's my task to introduce someone who, after all of these years, needs no formal introduction. Can I ask the CEO of Markham Stovall Hospital Foundation, Ms. Suzette Strong, to come up to the stage? While she does, I would also like to recognize the CEO of the hospital, Ms. Joanne Marr, who is also doing such a wonderful job.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, families and friends. I'm really standing before you this evening on behalf of all of the leaders that are in the room from Markham Stovall Hospital and the Markham Stovall Hospital Foundation. Among you, many of our physician leaders, you'll hear from somebody later on this evening, our board leaders, our hospital leaders, and so it's a privilege for me to be representing Markham Stovall before you today to express our deepest gratitude for all that you've done to enable Martin Stovall Hospital to be the community hospital that it is today, and to help ensure the extraordinary future that is enabled because people come together and so generously support healthcare. But if I had to actually point out one group that I'd like to thank you for the most, it would be the patients whose lives are impacted directly by the funds raised at tonight's dinner. We treat hundreds of patients a day, tens of thousands of patients a year, and many of you may be familiar with them. You might be sitting right next to them. So on behalf of all of those people whose lives you've impacted and whose health you've made better through Markham Stovall Hospital, I'd like to thank you so very much on behalf of everybody here. Thank you. Have a great night.
Now it is my pleasure to have our very special donors to the stage for recognition. I would ask Mr. Shakir Rahmatulla to be joined on stage by the Cabinet Ministers present, event co-chairs Khalid Usman and Markham Mayor Frank Serpitti, MPPs, and the Markham Stovall Hospital CEO, Markham Stovall Hospital Foundation CEO, so we can officially recognize the exceptional special donor.
Is getting another recognition, another award, because this is one guy that you can count on every time you need money for the hospital. This year alone, as you saw, that we will be giving $250,000 to the hospital, of which $100,000 is coming from Shakir Rahmatulla. So please give him a big hand.
Recognized.
My dear friends, have you got your photograph, Shakir? Yes, please go ahead and take your photo, because then we have one more recognition. Now here is one more gentleman that you have seen year after year after year contributing. He has already given in our past $2,100,000, but tonight he is committing a new $100,000 for the hospital, Hasnan. mashallah. He's a real generous individual in Markham. So, Mayor Scabini, are you proud of him? Helena, Madam Health Minister, if I could request you to come here. Yes, Helena Jazek, Minister of Health, if you can come up here. As you saw, we have these two generous individuals in your city, in your ward, in your riding, sorry, I should say. I think I'd like you to say a few words and to their generosity, both Shakir and Hasnat.
Thank you, Khalid, and two of the most outstanding, generous contributors to the Markham Stonewall Hospital, I would like to say thank you. What I always like to say is government cannot do everything for everybody. Obviously, we need to play our part, but the generosity of the community is really essential when we talk about our hospital community, because the hospital is for the community. We all have a piece of our incredible Markham Stonewall Hospital. Thank you so very, very much. I was so happy to be able to make the announcement today. Mayor Scarpitti made reference to it. We are increasing the operating budget of the Markham Stonewall Hospital by $10.1 million. In view of, obviously, the pressures on the hospital, we in York Region know the growing population, we know. Thankfully, we are an aging community. I learned one very interesting statistic. By 2040, so that's 20 years from now, we will have four times the number of people over the age of 90 that we have now. So I'm telling my staff I will still be around in 2040 to drive them crazy. Thank you so much for your incredible generosity.
So now, for the most exciting part of your evening, dinner will be served. And if anyone has not bought any raffle tickets as yet, we will begin drawing our first few raffle prizes as you guys eat dinner. Thank you.
everyone coming up
and cheer. Performed in the movie The Life of Pi.
Go ahead.
And we also have a thumb up for player Krishna. So enjoy.
Ready with this one? 1, 2, 3. Okay, perfect. I'll go for one more. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, wonderful. Thank you.
Okay, so before we start our first raffle draws for the evening, if anyone has lost an earring, please come find me. I have it.
Everyone, check your raffle tickets. 0792.
2357.
song for them.
This person is a very
famous orthopedic surgeon, Dr. Yasser Heller, is here. I'd like to ask him to please come up. Today we are also, Yasser is going to bring up two of his patients so that you know what is happening at Markham Stouffville Hospital, why we keep supporting Markham Stouffville, even though when somebody made a comment that the government is giving so much money, then why do we raise money? The reason is because for the equipment, the government does not give any money. So we as community have to raise, even though they give for operations. So I'm going to ask Dr. Heller to introduce his two patients that have gone through a personal experience. I would have asked my wife because she went through that through Dr. Heather. And you know, since that day, it's very difficult for me to catch up to her. She is always running. So, Dr. Heather.
Mr. Ali Asghar Durrani, Dr. Abdul Osman, and Mr. Coker.
If you could just tell your own personal story about Marco Stovall, their experience with the media placements they've had there. Thank you so much. Dr. Abda Usman.
Assalamu alaikum. Well, I wasn't prepared for this, but since one of his patients ran away, so I had to come running because he gave me such beautiful knee replacements. It was done about 4 years ago, and since that time, I think I have wheels under my feet rather than having knee replacements because I've been traveling so much and running with these knees. Dr. Heather, really, he did a wonderful job. He replaced both my knees at the same time, and I was back to work on the third week. It was third week that I went back to my office and I started working. And the only thing I really regret that he doesn't give me permission is for para jump. I asked him if I could go, and he says, no, you will break those and I will not be able to fix. So I don't know how he will not be able to fix if I break them again. So please give me permission so that I can go for my para jump.
Thank you, Dr. Haider, for allowing me to share my experience with you, especially my pain before and after my surgery. I was suffering from knee pain for a long time, and the pain was so acute that I couldn't do my daily activities, and especially when I was playing golf, I had difficulty finishing the round. Last year, I was in Dubai, and I was doing my walk, and my knees locked on me. So when I came back, my doctor sent me to Markham Stowell Hospital, to the joint assessment, and I knew I was in good hands because Dr. Haider was there. So when he told me that I need to go for surgery, I went on my last trip, came back, and he took me in, and since then, my pain is, it's been 7 weeks now, I'm feeling much, much better, and hopefully I should be able to do what I was doing before the pain. So thank you, Dr. Haider.
So, quickly if I can ask, Mayor Scarpini, Minister Rajab Maridi, Council General Imran Siddiqui Saab, please come up to the podium, Joanne and Suzette, if you can both join us. One of the important thing is to recognize the sponsors. So, our gold sponsor is Kyle Moore Homes. If there are a representative from Kyle Moore, would appreciate if they can come up to receive their plaque. Is there somebody from Kyle Moore Homes that can come up? All right.
Thank you.
I know that we have representatives from the Turkish Airlines, so if they can come up from Turkish Airlines, they have given us a sponsorship of $7,500, and the tickets that they've given us are going to be drawn in the raffle. And I'd also like to ask the Council General of Turkey, Erdin Özsen, to please join us on the stage. I know Dr. Basin, where are you? I know you're in your scrubs, so if you can come out. Dr. Basin with his Clarity Eye Institute has donated, he's our gold sponsor, and he has donated an operation for laser of both eyes, so it's going to be drawn. So Basin, if you're in the, come on up. You look like a doctor in the right place.